Hello students, in our previous e-lectures on operation on rational numbers, we had discussed about the properties of addition of rational numbers. Today we are going to discuss about the properties of subtraction of rational numbers. The first property, as we did in addition, x plus y, y plus x, they are equal. This is commutative law of addition. But in case of subtraction, for rational number x and y, x minus y is not equal to y minus x. That is, commutative law of subtraction doesn't hold true. I'm taking one example, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, here 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2. I'm going to take the LCM, 3 minus 2. Here the LCM is same, 2 minus 3. Here the result is 1 by 6. Here it is minus 1 by 6. The result isn't same. It is not same. So commutative property doesn't hold true for subtraction. Next property is the second. As we did in addition, associative law is true for addition of rational numbers. We are just changing the grouping, but the result is same. But in case of subtraction, for three numbers x, y and z, the associative law doesn't hold true for subtraction. But the values will not be equal. This property doesn't hold true for subtraction. Third property we discussed about the identity element. Now identity element of subtraction, identity element of subtraction doesn't exist. See, if I'm saying x minus 0, the result is x, but 0 minus x is equal to minus x. So identity element of subtraction doesn't exist. The fourth property which I am going to discuss about the inverse for subtraction. Inverse for subtraction does not arise, because as identity element for subtraction doesn't exist, therefore inverse for subtraction doesn't arise. It's arise. So, as all the properties we have discussed about the addition of rational number, all that four properties doesn't hold for subtraction. Now we are going to solve some questions based on the subtraction of rational numbers. One first question I am to take, minus 3 by 8 minus 6 by 20. Now we know that the addition and subtraction of rational numbers can be done by taking LCM. The LCM of 8 and 20 is 40. 40 divided by 8, 5 multiplied by minus 3, minus 15. This sign is for subtraction. 40 divided by 22 multiplied with minus 6, minus 12. Now, when two negative signs coming together, minus, minus, plus. Again, the situation arises. One is negative number, other is positive. Subtract the smaller number from the bigger number and put the sign of the bigger number ahead. Minus 3 by 40. In this way, we can do the subtraction of rational numbers. One form which I had discussed now, another form is subtract 5 by 11 from minus 8 by 23. Now, I have to subtract 5 by 11 from minus 8 by 23. So, minus 8 by 23 should be written first. and I have to subtract 5 by 11 from this number. As I know that 23 and 11 both are co-prime number, so their LCM will be their product. 253 divided by 23 will give you 11. 11 multiplied by 8 minus 88. 253 multiplied by 11 will give you 23 multiplied by 5 minus 115. Both number are negative. Add them and put negative sign. Minus 203 by 253. I'm taking one more example. Subtract minus 5 by 7 from 0. Now I have to subtract minus 5 by 7 from 0. So 0 has to be written first. Subtract what? Minus 5 by 7. Now 0 is 0. It has no value. What we have to take care of is minus minus plus. 0 plus 5 by 7. The result is 5 by 7. Hopefully you have understood all the properties which we have discussed today. So home assignment for today is, do question number 1, 2, worksheet 2, chapter 2.